Tragedy and agony have cast a somber mood over hundreds of people in Bulambuli district following the mudslides, leaving them homeless. The disaster was triggered by torrential rains that started pounding on Sunday, October 27, 2024 evening, stretching through Monday morning. The villages affected include Chifudu, Chikuyu, Nachitembeti, Nambeche, Lukungu, Chikolo West, and Mapera in Namisuni, Elgon North County. According to Ramzan Netwala, the head of disaster management in the district, over 20 households were buried in rubble, while 371 people have been displaced.
We have come to witness what took place yesterday, but one, there is a lot of damages on the side of houses, coffee, tree, graves, overcados, and everything. There is nothing on the ground. Things have, the soil has turned other way around things. You find that it has come up with a normal tree whereby it has been transformed to another place. Especially the graves, which have been taken out from very far to a place where it was not supposed to be. And you can as well witness the structures.
Twala, who doubles as the Assistant Chief Administrative Officer, added that the number of affected people could still go up owing to the fact that they are still mapping the general damage left behind by the disaster. At the current Namisuni sub-county headquarters and the neighboring schools and churches, the situation is dire owing to the fact that basic needs, including food and water, are hard to come by. By press time, the office of the Prime Minister, OPM, had sent officials on the ground to assess the situation and provide tents to shelter the displaced who are now camped at Namisuni sub-county headquarters and neighboring schools and churches. The Cabinet has put the Criminal Investigations Directorate, CID, of the Uganda Police Force on notice to apprehend permanent secretaries and other government accounting officers responsible for payroll fraud, including ghost workers and irregular recruitment in their respective agencies. The decision was arrived at during the cabinet meeting at State House Entebbe on Monday after the Minister of Public Service, Muruli Mukasa, presented a report on the special audit of the government payroll. The audit that was conducted by the Office of the Auditor General has unearthed multiple government ministries, departments and agencies that have ghost workers on the payroll, overpaying workers, underpaying workers, and workers who were not properly recruited, among other irregularities. While addressing journalists at the media center yesterday, the Minister of ICT and National Guidance, Dr. Chris Bariomunsi, revealed that the CID has been put on high alert to immediately act against accounting officers who will be found to have facilitated payroll fraud.
Either the accounting officers and the government officials who will have been found to have allowed discrepancies in the payroll, like say paying people who have left the service or who do not exist, will be prosecuted.
The cabinet has constituted the committee to support the Minister of Public Service to perfectly investigate the matter. That committee is composed of the Minister of Science, Technology and Innovation, Dr. Monica Musenero, the Minister of Gender, Labour and Social Development, Betty Amoi, and the Minister of State for Industry, David Bahati.
We also found that there are some civil servants who never showed up for the verification, but the work is still ongoing.